Welcome to the Cozy Noah Vibes. I'm your host, Noah. Thank you for choosing to join us. Before we begin, find a comfortable position and set aside all tasks. Let's enter a state of calmness together. First, let's take a deep breath together. Inhale slowly and then exhale gently. Repeat a few times to deepen and regulate your breath. Now, use your senses to feel every part of your body. From head to toe, notice any tension or discomfort. Simply acknowledge their presence without trying to change them. As you continue to breathe deeply, let's gradually release the tension from your body, starting from the head, moving downwards. Gently release each muscle and feel the comfortable lightness, as if an invisible comforting hand is gently embracing you. Shift your focus to your thoughts. Don't attempt to eliminate them. Just let them quietly drift by, like clouds drifting in the sky. You are merely an observer, unaffected by these thoughts. Let's take another deep breath and absorb the tranquil and peaceful energy. In this moment, you are safe and serene. Anything can wait until tomorrow. Thank you for participating in tonight's scientific relaxation session. May you have a peaceful night. Now, as you gradually drift off to sleep, let's listen to a story. Fondi's wife, Leizu, was also very capable. She taught people to raise silkworms and developed a set of experiences for feeding, reeling silk, and weaving cloth. From then on, people not only knew how to make clothes and headwear, but also shoes, completely changing the primitive habit of wearing tree leaves and animal skins in ancient times. Legend has it that Leizu was born in the ancient Siling country 5,000 years ago. She was a beautiful and skilled girl named Leizu, raised single-handedly by her father after losing her mother at a young age. Later, her father went off to war for years, leaving Leizu alone at home. With nothing much to do, Leizu often went out to play with other girls from the village. However, as they were all girls, they couldn't wander too far. After exploring the nearby areas thoroughly, Leizu started to feel bored. One day, Leizu thought of the mulberry grove outside the village, where they had never been before. So she invited a few girls to go with her. In the mulberry grove, they found many white berries. The girls were excited and collected a lot to take back home. When they returned, Leizu wanted to taste the berries, so she took a bite. To her surprise, not only were the berries tasteless, but they were also hard to chew. Leizu thought that maybe these berries were not meant to be eaten raw and needed to be boiled. She quickly boiled a pot of water and poured all the white berries into it. After boiling for a while, Leizu took one out to taste, but it was still hard. Could it be that she hadn't boiled them long enough? Leizu continued boiling for a long time, but even then, the berries remained hard. Frustrated, Leizu grabbed a wooden stick and vigorously stirred the pot. After stirring for a while, Leizu got tired and took the stick out, only to find it covered with fine white threads. Leizu had never seen such threads before. She continued to stir in the pot with the stick, and gradually, when Leizu touched them, they felt sturdy, unlike spider silk, but they were tangled. Leizu thought that the tangled threads were of no use, so she set them aside and went to the house to rest. While she was sleeping, the Queen Mother of the West came to her in a dream and said, "Clever child, although these threads from the cocoons are tangled, they can be woven into brocade." After that, she taught Leizu how to reel the silk without tangling and how to weave brocade. When Leizu woke up, she was curious and went back to the mulberry grove to observe for many days. She found that silkworms fed on mulberry leaves would grow fatter and eventually turn into cocoons filled with silk threads in their bellies. She found some plump white silkworms on the mulberry trees and picked many mulberry leaves, then brought them home. At first, Leizu called the insects on the tree skyworms, then silkworms, and the small round balls they spun cocoons. Back home, Leizu first laid a thick layer of mulberry leaves in a large basket, then placed the silkworms inside. After the silkworms turned into cocoons, she separated the cocoons by color and boiled them in a large pot. After boiling for a while, she used a small wooden stick to pick up a thread, reeling it while picking, and soon she had many shiny silk cocoons. Following the pattern of the weaving machine shown to her by the Queen Mother in her dream, Leizu asked her father to help her make a weaving machine. Then, she started weaving according to the steps taught by the Queen Mother. The resulting brocade was colorful and beautiful. She wove the fine silk into cloth, replacing tree leaves and animal skins, which were light, warm, and convenient for work. Under Leizu's guidance, all the women in the village started raising silkworms and spinning silk, making many beautiful clothes out of silk. In commemoration of Leizu's achievements, she was known as the Silkworm Goddess or the First Silkworm Mother. One spring day, Leizu was still raising silkworms in the mulberry grove as usual. At this time, a man saw her wearing beautiful silk clothes. He had never seen such beautiful clothes and asked Leizu how they were made. Leizu explained the principles of planting mulberry trees, raising silkworms, and reeling silk to the man. The man realized that the people where he lived still lived a primitive life, wearing animal skins in winter and covering themselves with leaves in summer. He immediately admired this woman and asked her to come with him to help his people. Leizu agreed and married the man, who turned out to be Huandi. After becoming Huandi's primary wife, Leizu brought the techniques of planting mulberry trees and raising silkworms to Huandi's tribe. With her diligence and wisdom, she became Huandi's logistical support. She organized a large number of women to raise silkworms and weave brocade, among whom was a particularly clever woman who always solved various problems. Leizu thought highly of this woman's virtue and secretly arranged for her to marry Huandi. However, this woman was ugly, and at first, she didn't catch Wandi's attention. Later, when she invented the spinning wheel and loom, Huandi began to value her. With Leizu's strong support, this ugly woman eventually became Huandi's secondary wife, and later generations honored her as Mother Mo. May you have a deep and peaceful sleep on this tranquil night. Let pleasant dreams accompany you all through the night, until the first light of dawn. Looking forward to our next meeting. Good night, and may you have sweet dreams.
Thank you.